Today we are going to see the another concept called as material determination. Okay. So we also come across this scenario. We go to supermarket, okay, and we are looking for some things. So let me say we go to, do you people any have preference of brand in rice or atta? Okay. So, okay, let me say, like, I am regularly taking the Annapurna atta. Okay. I go to market one fine day. Okay. And I am finding that instead of, I am not finding the Annapurna atta. Okay. So, I go to the sales counter or I approach the, someone, anybody of the sales person and ask them, like, I want Annapurna atta. Okay. The salesman says, have you ever noticed the almost in every store, the salesman never say no. If you say like Annapurna atta is not there, they will say you can find the some other atta. Okay. If you say like, okay, I am not finding the article A, they will say, ma'am, you can see the article B in the thing. Okay. Which means they are equating or substituting the product with another equivalent. Okay. So let us see from store perspective. Okay. Today I am handling article A. Yes. Oh, sorry. Right. Lot of participants. I will paste in that Skype messenger. So, let us see things from store perspective or seller perspective. I am handling an article A. Okay. For some reason, hereafter, I am not able to handle article A. But that doesn't mean I am going to lose the market share or of the particular equivalent. For example, let me say I am handling particular any. Okay, the same atta example. Okay, so I am selling almost 5,000 kilos of kgs of atta every month. Okay, on fine day, Annapurna atta says like, okay, for some reason, they couldn't supply you, or you find some terms not it is not possible working with them, so you want to break them. Okay, so which doesn't mean like you have to lose that 5,000 kg sales of atta every month. Okay, it means a lot of money. So what normally you do? You normally replace it with a other alternative or equivalent or substitute, whatever we call. Okay. So we do that. Okay. That is one scenario. There is another scenario. Okay. So we are handling, so let me talk about Cadbury chocolates. Cadbury chocolates we normally sell in pieces or sometimes like small assorted packs. Okay. But whenever these festivals or occasions come, Diwali or the New Year or whatever, any function comes. Okay. Have you noticed that all the normal packs in the shelves are automatically replaced with these functional gift wrapped packs or with the beautiful boxes or cartons, okay, which is almost like, which helps me like in serving directly. Okay. So, for a particular period of time, you might want to replace a regular article with a special article. Okay. In this kind of scenario, we use a functionality called as material determination in SD. Okay. Material determination, okay, the name itself suggests, okay, when you enter a material, the system must automatically replace it with some other material, with equivalent material. Okay. So this replacement can be done for various reasons, okay, for various reasons, and the output also can be varied. For example, if I enter an article, the system can automatically replace it without any warning or without any pop-up message. Okay. The system immediately replaces it with another article. Okay. And there is some other scenario. The system where, let me say like that, I have auto brand A and auto brand B. Okay. So both auto brand A, I have 5000 kgs. Okay. Auto brand B, I have another 5000 kgs. Okay. The customer comes and asks for 10,000 kg of auto. Okay. Auto A. Okay. So what the system does, either it can say complete quantity is not available, so I can give you a partial quantity, else it can be said that, okay, I will give you 5000 kgs of auto A and replace the remaining 2000 kgs with the equivalent product, that is auto B. Okay. So in this case, the substitution is made based on the availability check. And there is one more thing. So when this is in the continuation with the last scenario, the customer asks for 7000 kgs of auto A, but right now you have 5000 kgs of auto A and 5000 kgs of auto B. So in your sales order, when you create, the system creates 5002 schedule lines, okay, one with 5000 kgs of auto A and another one with 2000 kgs of auto B, that is the substitution product. Okay. And your delivery is being created, scheduled for next week. But tomorrow you are getting another consignment of auto A, which means you now your stock goes up to 10,000 kgs of auto A. So by the time the delivery is being created, the system checks the material determination or material availability again and finds that, okay, auto A is available in whole quantities as per the customer's request. So the system, in the delivery, system replaces the auto A with 7000 kgs and the auto B is made as 0 kgs. Okay. So these are the scenarios based on the article availability. Okay. So whenever I had said that, I mean, like it's almost like a thumb rule. Whenever we say something is being determined, okay, so the system automatically uses the condition technique. So this also uses the condition technique, and let us see that. Okay. So I go to display IMG. So this is my basic functionality. So I go to basic functions. I go to material determination. Okay. As usual, I am going to define any, any condition table, access sequence, condition type, etc. Okay. So, I had created another table, table number 2. Okay. So, I am going to use that. So, I am going to access sequence. There are two access sequence. One is material enter. I go to the access, I could see there is only one table, which means just on the material entered, the system takes up the value. It doesn't check for whether which sales organization it has to belong to or which customer it has to do for, nothing like that. Okay. So I go to field, okay. I can see only one, that is MATWA. Whereas in the another sequence, A002, there are two tables. One is, it looks for the sales organization distribution channel and metal. That is a sort of specific one. Okay. Then it goes to the material enter. Okay. So shall we do one thing? So we will create another table for customer. Okay. So we will create a condition table. Page down, sales organization, page up, distribution channel, we'll take customer and material entered. So I am trying to be more specific. It means the system must, I want the system to look into the first whether anything exists for customer specific record and then go for further broader categories. Okay. So I have created this. I go to technical view. Okay. METW is there. Okay. This is my text field. Based on this, I am going to make the entry. The remaining three are the header ones. Okay. So I come back. I do the table generation. It's going to be a local object. So now I am going to add this table in my access sequence. So in the second one, so I am going to add, so instead of 10, okay, along with the 10, I am going to add a 5, my table number 503, local, which is fine. So I am going to initialize that doing the priming activity. So okay, I have initialized. So I determination. Then once I have done the access sequence, what I have to do? Hello. No, no, I have created an access sequence. Okay. After that. Yeah. What happened? Is Abid there? Oh, something is wrong with Abid today. I didn't hear you at all today. So, customer and material entered. So, I have created a new condition type A002 and I have assigned the this thing, access sequence we have just created to that. Okay. So now you have, okay, actually the standard is normally A001 only. Okay, the system, standard SAP system comes with A001. Okay, so the rest are all what we have created. Okay. So now I have created the condition type. And I have to assign it to the some procedure. Okay, so maintain procedure. Okay, so let me copy. Copy. So instead of A001, I am entering a 2. Material determination. Customer. So I go into this control data and I find instead of A001 I am checking it A002 customer. Okay. So can anybody say the pricing procedure determination or free goods procedure determination? Hmm? documentation to the class? Yeah, correct. For this combination, the system creates the determines the tracing procedure. Okay. But in our case, it is not like that. So in our case, you are directly assigning, if this is a document type, then use this determination procedure. Okay. So today I am going to use the treaties document type, BOR3. Standard sales order, okay. Instead of A001, I am going to replace it with A002. Okay. Because I just want to the standard one, there is only one condition type, that is only the material enter. Okay. Instead of that, I want to create something specific. If this is the customer, replace. Else, you handle it normally. Okay. So to do that, I don't want to mess up with the standard one, so I am using the species. So now I have created the condition types, I have created the procedures, and I had assigned the procedures to document type. Okay. So now to make sure that these things work, I have to create the condition records. Okay. So let me go to logistics, sales and distribution, master data, products, material determination. Okay. So create. I'm going to create. So I'm going to create for the condition type A002. So first I'm going to create for some specific customer. So for this customer T62A01, okay, this is what, okay, to replace a material with some other material, which means the origin material need not have a material master record. Okay, for example, here I can enter anything, dummy. Okay, for that I am replacing it with AT103. I don't have any material called as dummy. Okay, instead of okay, I can even say original. Okay, I need not have the material master for the material entered eventually, which is going to be substituted. Okay, so in this case, like so, most of the time it happens like the customer the. As a seller, we normally use this functionality. So, which means, like, ideally speaking, you must have a material that is to be that will be substituted by some other material. Okay, but to get it substituted, you need not have a material master. No, need not. For material determination, it need not. Okay. So here is the reason. Okay. So there are 8 reasons. Okay. Then leave it. Okay. Okay, I want the system to replace an article. I am going to enter PAT101. Okay, so for some reasons, let me say I am discontinuing this product, and I need to substitute it with some other product. Okay, so I am replacing PAT101 with 102. Okay. My reason is 1. So let me save it. /MEA01. Okay. We are checking for the treaty sales order type. Material determination. So 1, the system automatically replaced 1 with 2. Have you noticed? It didn't give any warning, it didn't give any indication that it is going to be changed or something. Okay. However, if you go into the item details, in the sales area data, sales A, you can see that this is being a substituted article and the material entered was T80101. It is being recorded that this article that is appearing in the sales order is not the originally intended one, instead it is being, so even though this data is not explicit in anywhere in the your sales order, okay, you can find it inside the item details. Okay. So this is okay. Yeah. So my okay, that is there. Okay. Anyway, like that is out of SAP. You can always inform me from the moment you receive the PO, you inform them that okay, you are being replacing. I mean, you are now replacing the article with something else. Okay. That is out of SAP. Yeah. So let me do it for the another customer. Okay. Okay. So now for another customer, I am entering the same article for which I have created the condition records. Okay. In this case, the system didn't replace because we had maintained the condition records for material information for a particular customer. That is for customer A01, we maintained. If I enter 101, the system has replaced it with 102. That is why it worked well in the first line. Then I changed the customer to A02 and I entered the same article, that is 101. This time the system didn't change anything. So that is, which means our condition records of creating with reference and with specific, I mean creating for specifically for customer, it is working fine. Okay. So let us go to the metal determination again and we can maintain some other condition records. Okay. Before that, so we have been seeing that I entered 01. The system replaced it. So another one is okay for this customer. Okay, I am using the availability, which means I am telling the system you check for the availability of the material. If it is available, you take up whatever quantity is available and fill it up with the remaining quantity. So let me say T-AT-103. Okay. Here I have to enter the material which is supposed to be replacing it. For example, if I have one article that has more than one equivalent or substitute, then I have to fill the first one which I have to start it. For example, I have article number A 100 pieces, okay. Article number B 100 pieces, article number C 100 pieces. My customer wants article A 150 pieces, okay. Now I can tell the system which one to be populated first. For example, okay, fill the A 100 pieces and for remaining take the article B. If that is the case, which one has to come first? My article A has to come first, okay. If sometimes it happens like if somebody asks for article A, first deplete the article B. I mean, once it is finished or once it is completely sold out, then you finish it with the article A. Okay. In such cases, article B must be given in the first order. So let's, I'm saying the system must fill with article 103, that is the same article first, and for the remaining quantity the system must take the another article. So for I'm giving the order alternative material. First the system must fill the 103, for remaining quantity it must fill 104. And since this is my alternate article, I am saying that okay, carry out the MRP indication or MRP check for the alternative. Okay. Is it clear? That is, so in the alternate I am saying which is going to be my first one. If the quantity is not available sufficiently, then which one has to be filled first? And here. Okay. I am saving it. Okay. For this customer we have created. Okay. Slash NVA01. Material determination. So it is one T-AFT103. I know that is somewhere around 10,000 pieces in the stock right now. So I am putting 15,000 pieces. Okay. What happened? So do one thing. /OMNDE. I'm checking for the stock in the transaction code MNBE and taking up the in the plant 1200. Okay, 10,000 pieces only is there. And then /NVB12, that is for this, for the customer. Material entered. Okay. I had told the system if this has to be done. Okay. /NVE01 15,000 pieces. AT102, and marking it as alternative one. Okay, so the problem is okay. There is something called as availability check. So whenever you create a sales order, you create sales order, obviously that quantity or requirement from the sales order will be taken to the others, either production department or purchasing department, saying that today I have received an order for so and so quantity, so please arrange to produce it or purchase it. This we call it as transfer of requirements. And the transfer of requirements is done either on individual basis. That is, whenever the moment you create a sales order, the transaction, the requirement will be sent to the concerned department. Else, it will be consolidated for the whole day, and then it will be taken to the concerned department, either production or procurement. Okay. So, while carrying out the availability check, we'll see about the availability check later. Okay. So, while carrying out the availability check, we will be doing it either on daily requirement basis or individual requirement basis. Okay. So, your material determination works fine when it is set as individual requirement. That is, the system is your system need not wait for the end of the day to consolidate all the requirements and send to the production or purchasing. Okay. So, I had maintained the availability check as individual requirement for 101 and 102. Okay. So, that is why it has worked, whereas for 103, it was not maintained that way. To check that availability thing, so I go to MM02. Choose the MRT3 view. My plant is 1200, storage location is 001. Here I can see the availability check, that is the individual requirement. Okay. So let me check for other article. MRP 3 1200. Okay. Here it is in the 01, that is the daily requirement, which means the system has to consolidate everything and then take it to the concerned department at the end of the day. So that is why it didn't work for us. So we'll use this material for some other example. So I come to the logistics, sales and distribution, master data, product, material determination, okay, change mode. So this is what we had entered for the particular customer. I am asking the system to replace the material. First I am asking the system, if anybody asks for the quantity, first enter this quantity, this material for the shortage of the quantities, substitute with the another material. Okay. So now I am going to tell the system I want to get rid of 102. So whomever asks 101, first give them 102 so that I can deplete the stock, and then you can start using the 101. So I am now changing the order or priority. So, 1. Okay. Did you understand the logic? Okay. So, I am going to create a. So, before that, let me let's open sales order. I have to come out of there. So this is a customer and determine the material. If somebody asks 101, the system must first fill it up with 102. Once 102 stock is depleted, then only it must go for 101. So that is our logic here. So I am putting 12,000 pieces. Can you see the system first took the 102, not the 101. So based on the order of your alternate material in your condition record, the system takes up and fills that first. Okay. Then only it goes for the remaining quantity. Is it clear? Something is missing in today's class. So now we had said one is automatic substitution, one is availability based substitution, and we have something called as, so in both the cases it's not automatic, which means the moment something is not found, the system automatically populated. Okay, but you are not given any choice in this. For example, you know that article 101 can be replaced with 102, 103 or 104, whatever it could be. Okay. So, you know that for article 101, you have three alternatives. Okay. But in both the scenarios which we have seen now, you didn't have a choice to pick other than what system is proposing. Okay. To fulfill that, so now we are going to see the manual product selection. So before that, let me clear out the condition record. Slash NVB, 11 is for creating, 12 is for changing. Okay. For this customer, okay, whatever I had maintained, 101 and 103. So let me delete these things. Now I am going to choose the item reason number. One thing is, like, did you notice there is a proposed reason in the header and there is a proposed reason in the item level. Okay. So before you enter anything, if you enter the proposed reason here, okay, that will be automatically copied to all the items you enter in the footer level or text area. Okay. But after you make the entries here, then you change the proposed reason in the header, it won't be copied. Okay. So, and the system gives priority to the proposed reason defined at the item level, not at the header level. Okay. So, I am saying 5 is my manual product selection. Okay. So, I am saying if anybody enters T-AT101, replace it with T-AT 102. Okay. So I want to give propose more alternatives or choices for 101. So I am saying T-AT 103, T-AT 104, T-AT 105. Okay. This is not an automatic selection, so I am not proposing any MRC indication. Now if you want, I mean, for example, if you are working on the scenario where you are substituting the articles based on availability, then you have to enable that MRP indicator for your alternative material. Okay. In my case, in this case, it is not that I am working on availability based. Instead, I am working on the manual selection or choice based. So, I am not entering any MRP indicator. Okay, I have entered everything. Save it. Okay. Create a sales order, slash NVA01, okay, GOR3, for this customer, material determination, T-AT101, 10 pieces. The system gives me a pop-up saying that you had asked for AT101, 10 pieces, on so-and-so date. Okay. For this, I have so many alternatives. Okay, 102, 103, and on the requested delivery date, how many pieces of articles will be available? So that is in the required delivery date quantity. Okay. If you want to take item 102, it is having 9,914 pieces. So I have to check why this is showing almost infinity here. Okay. So the system gives you an option of choosing the product manually. So, I may go for 102 or 103. So, let me take 102, press enter, system replaces it with this thing. So, replaces 101 with 102. So, this is the manual selection. No, for 005, it is not automatic selection, it is manual selection. Sir, now we will see like how and why this, based on the reasons we are giving, how it is being activated. Okay. Before that, can you see that now there is, except you go into the item details, and see what is the actual material entered in the sales order printout. Okay, there is no indication of whether this is a originally entered material or a substituted material. So you might want, based on your business user requirement, you might want to create the substituted article as a sub-item and the original article as the main item. Okay. That is what we saw in our quantity. Okay. Did you remember? In the first line, the original entered quantity was there. Below that, 11 and 12 were the substituted items, which means you have an indication, okay, I had entered the article 101 for 12,000 pieces, but the system did an availability check and returned 101 9,000 pieces and 102 as 3,000 pieces. Okay, there was an indication, okay, something was being worked. Okay, but in this case it is not there. So you can also control whether you have to make a display of the article entered along with the replaced one. So let us go to the substitution region. Material determination, we had defined the procedures, okay, we had defined the condition tables, procedures, everything. When we create the condition records, we enter the substitution reasons. The substitution reasons only control how it is being done. For example, we entered 1, 4 and 5. Okay. If you give an entry, okay, so the system, while you are making the entry, the system will say like this article. Okay, so if you make entry, so when you are printing the sales order, the system will say like you had entered so and so article, and if you enable the warning, the system will give you a yellow ribbon or something saying that you had entered the article which is being substituted by so and so article. Okay. So this is one other one. Okay. Then is the strategy. Strategy says where it, how it has to be done, whether automatic means the moment it created, the moment you enter the original article and press the enter button, the system will not give any warning. Instead, it automatically changes the product. Okay. And if you choose A, the system gave a pop-up. So that is why if you see the reason number 5, the strategy is A, that is the substitute products are displayed. Okay. From that you are going to, you have to make a selection. And B is, in the substitution we had seen that on that particular date what is the available quantity. Okay. If I choose this B, the system won't do any availability check for that particular date. Instead, it will just show you what are all the alternates. It doesn't bother whether sufficient quantity is available on particular date or not. It won't show anything. Okay. So this is the difference between A and B. So normally, manual selection uses the A and B. Okay. Then is the outcome. Outcome is what, how the system displays in your sales order. For example, in our 001, outcome is blank. That is why the system is automatically replacing the original article with the substituted article. Okay. And if you choose A, it will give you it will create the substituted articles as a sub-item. Okay. And if you choose B, for example, like we have seen the copy control. So whatever you had used in the sales order, that will be copied to the delivery. So we have even given the option of copying the item number or not. Okay. But in this case, if you choose the B, for example, let me say my original article is article A, which is replaced with article B. So in my sales order, it will show article A as main item, article B as sub item, that is 11. Okay. But when this is copied to the delivery, if I had chosen the outcome as B, the system won't copy the main item in the delivery. Instead, it will copy only the sub-items which has the required delivery quantity in the delivery. So here you can choose when it has to be done, whether it has to be done either in the sales order only or at the delivery also. Okay. Then finally is the substitution, and this is normally used for service items. For example, when you are making an entry for a physically deliverable item, but it is being replaced with the service item. Okay. So this setting is normally related with the PLM, plant maintenance, okay, where they deal mostly with the services. But as far as our SD is concerned, we are most bothered about strategy and outcome. And whether the entry must be there or warning must be there, that is, I mean, that you have to take that call. Okay. So let me maintain that I need a warning in the 001. So I save it. I create a condition record for the slash NVB12. I am now I am replacing it 1. I don't need many. I am creating slash NVA01 0R3. The system gives a reason. Material 102 is found on the basis of entry and why it is being replaced. Okay, it is just a warning. So I press enter. The system takes it up. So here actually the user is given an indication that the article is being changed instead of what happened previously. Okay. Have you seen listing and exclusion? Have we seen listing and exclusion previously in any of our previous class? Not listing and exclusion, okay, no problem. So listing and exclusion means, example, you might want to deal with a customer for selling particular product only. Okay. You may have thousands of products, but with a particular customer, you may want to restrict your sales only to 5 or 10 or 100 items only. Okay. So in such cases, you can create a list for the customer. Okay. So that if you try to create any sales order for any material other than what is being given in that list, the system will give you an error saying that this is not listed for this customer, so you cannot raise a sales order. Okay. Exactly opposite is the exclusion. You may have 1000 products, but you want to restrict, or you don't want to sell these 100 articles to the particular customer. Okay. So in this case, maintaining a list of, let me say, 10,000 articles are there you are handling. Okay. Maintaining a listing of 9,900 articles is difficult. Okay. It is easy to say, okay, out of all this, don't sell these 10 only. So, for that purpose, you use the another functionality called as exclusion. For this particular customer, exclude these articles. So, you create another list. Based on that list, the system says, like when you are trying to create a sales order, the system will say, no, for this customer, this particular item is excluded. Okay. That doesn't have any setting at all in the IMG. So if I go to sales and distribution basic function, there is a listing and exclusion. Okay. So it as usual, it uses the condition technique. You can say, for this particular distribution channel, exclude so and so article. For this particular customer, exclude so and so article. Okay. So I am not going into this. So only thing is, like, I can activate what is the listing and exclusion for my order type. Just now, like how we did for material determination. Okay. For listing is A001 and exclusion is B001. So I go to front end, that is the easy access. Product, there is a listing and exclusion. First, let me create a listing. This is for customer and material. So I am saying for this customer A01, I am going to sell only two items, T-AT101, T-AT102. Only two items I am going to sell. So Clash N EA01. Listing. I had entered AT101, so the system will take it smartly. Okay. So AT103, 10 pieces. The system says AT103 is not listed and therefore not allowed. Okay. Because this customer is given only two items, that is 01 and 02. So if you try to make sales order other than this 101 and 102, system will give an error saying that it is not listed. Let us do the order type. Yeah. So let us do a ulta of this. Okay. So instead of listing, I am excluding those articles for the customer. Let me solution change for the customer. Because if you leave out any condition records open, That will affect your further sales order. Sometimes you will be wondering why it is not working, because some other condition record will be active at the time. So that is why I am clearing whenever I am done with. So exclusion. For this customer, I am excluding those only two articles. So Clash N VA01. For the same customer, exclusion. Okay, now I enter 103, which was not listed previously. Okay, so now it will take. If I try to enter 101, it will say the material has been excluded. It is a simple functionality but very useful, especially in case of sales and groceries. Groceries in the sense like grocery sales to supermarkets and hypermarkets, those kind of things. It will be very useful. Okay, so this is your listing and exclusion. I mean, like as usual, this is also using the same condition technique. Okay. As you have the procedures, condition tables, access sequences, okay, then you maintain the procedure. If you want, I mean, like if you want, you can create for a particular distribution channel and material. Okay. Right now we have only customer and material and customer hierarchy and material. You can create it for a particular distribution channel and then activate this exclusion functionality. Okay. So with this we have come close to almost all of the sales functionality. From tomorrow, we'll start with working with the delivery, and then we go to the. We can see the contracts and other things, but since that is more, we will have to create the deliveries for the thing to complete the reference and other things. Okay, so we will finish the deliveries and we will take up the contract, rebate, and credit management while we are going through the billing part. Okay.